Zoblon. Today we are going to take yet another guidance-based session, and today we are discussing all about mock tests. Why, as a judicial services aspirant, you must be more and more frequent with mock tests till you take the final exam. Aaj ka session important hai, so without delay, let us get started. Ek myth hai that examinations test your knowledge. Examinations do not test your knowledge, at least not competitive exams like judicial services examinations. They test your knowledge in comparison to others. They test your ability to answer the questions even with the limited knowledge that you have. What matters is application, and the only way to know how well you are prepared is by testing yourself. No one has done well in an exam without practicing any tests. There is not much you can achieve by only watching videos or attending lectures. Mock tests are the single most constant among toppers, and yet shockingly, a lot of people do not understand this. I will share what I think works. You might have your own strategy. If you don't, this video will help you. Mock exams are the best way to assess knowledge, in its highest precedence as well, because it is closer to reality, closer to the real exam. You can see each question as an independent scenario rather than being biased to a particular subject. When you take up subject tests, you are primarily protecting yourself. You don't want to fall. You don't want to take surprises. You want anticipated questions. This is not how real exams function. Here, it is like you have two additional training wheels on the bicycle. जो बचपन में चलाते थे दो एडिशनल व्हील होती थी आपकी बाइसिकल फॉल नहीं करे इसलिए सो व्हेन यू टेक सब्जेक्ट टेस्ट्स इट इज़ नॉट एज हेल्पफुल ग्रैंड टेस्ट्स और मॉक टेस्ट्स प्रोवाइड यू अनप्रेसिडेंटेड अमलगमेशन ऑफ सब्जेक्ट्स एंड दे कंपेल यू टू थिंक आउट ऑफ द बॉक्स दे कंपेल यू टू कोरिलेट कॉन्सेप्ट्स इवन इफ इन द वर्स्ट केस सिनेरियो यू डू नॉट रिटेन कॉन्सेप्ट्स यू डू नॉट रिमेंबर वॉट यू हैव रेड यू स्टिल आर एबल टू टेक एजुकेटेड गेसेस एंड दिस प्रैक्टिस इज इम्पॉर्टेंट अंडरस्टैंडिंग एलिमिनेशन टेक्निक्स टू कंक्लूड द फाइनल आंसर इज इम्पॉर्टेंट अपार्ट फ्रॉम दिस मॉक टेस्ट हेल्प यू फेमिलियराइज विद द फ्रीक्वेंटली आस्क्ड इम्पॉर्टेंट टॉपिक्स दिस बिकम्स सो रूटीन दैट यू विल स्टार्ट एंटिसिपेटिंग द क्वेश्चंस बाय द टाइम यू एंटर द एग्जाम फॉर एग्जाम्पल आप किसी मॉक टेस्ट पे जाते हैं एंड देन यू आस्क योरसेल्फ वेयर इज दैट रेस ज्यूडिकाटा वाला क्वेश्चन You will also get used to sitting, controlling hunger, controlling thirst, tuning yourself to a complete exam-like experience. It is important that when you take mock tests, aap mock tests ko laptops ya desktops pe le, never on the phone. Monitor is different. It will train your eyes to read the text. Wahan zoom in, zoom out ka system nahi hai. Create a total exam-like ambience. Do not quit in the middle of the exam. This will fail the purpose of the mock test. Make sure to keep distractions away. Calm down and attempt the exam. Once you are done with the tests, try to evaluate yourself by checking the solutions. So point number one is, for example, we at Edzorb provide you in-depth analytics of your performance. Use these analytics to improve your scores over time. Let me know on the comment section if you want me to explain how to use the analytics to interpret a mock test performance to the very best. Now, also depending on the preparation stage that you are, focus on questions that you got wrong. Or if you are new in the preparation, read the entire set of explanations to compare how you originally thought and how you should be thinking, how to approach the questions, which topics you need to focus, or sometimes just to confront for the topics you thought you knew but you don't. Ek question aata hai, what is a good score? Don't get too caught up on the scores. All that matters is, scores must be improving over time. You should not be repeating the same mistakes again and again. And when you've read the explanations, read these concepts, try to summarize it in one of your notebooks in the shortest possible format and revise it so that you do not repeat these mistakes again. Now, most students struggle to improve their scores. If you're one of them, do this. Identify your weak subjects. Sometimes weak also means the subjects that you deliberately procrastinate, subjects that haunt you. Subjects that are boring, subjects that are lengthy. Either way, whatever is your chemistry with the subjects you are ignoring, identify them and take that on priority. Cover topics that you've left out. In fact, also analyze how few shorter subjects together can be scoring and brush them up over time. A genuine concern over here is students believe that if they spend time on subjects that are weak, that the stronger subjects would go to a moderate level as well. And it's true, it's a genuine concern. Don't bother about hitting a plateau of this kind. What you can do is intermittently take some time out to revise the subjects that you are strong in as well. There is one thing that you must know. Do not attempt mocks by leaving any subject. At least attempt QBank modules. At least attempt past year papers before you have attempted any mock. But do not leave out a subject in its entirety. Another question that I face is, when should I start taking mock tests? Well, you should start taking mock tests yesterday. What I'm trying to say is, it is already late. The earlier the better, the more the merrier. Mock tests should be frequent. An ideal way to go forward is twice in a month, which you can increase over time to once every week, and at least 5 to 6 mocks in the last 30 to 40 days before the examination. If you have managed to listen to the video so far, we have a special section coming for you. First and foremost is, few students are fearful of mock tests. They think that they will score less and this will demoralize them. Well, when a small baby starts to walk, it will fall a few times. But this is a necessary change to endure, and so should you. Early in your preparation phase, you will score low initially. But that is just because you are learning to walk. You need to endure this over time. But surely and slowly, you will start performing better. Just trust yourself and give dedicated efforts. Even if you do not know anything, you are appearing to gain familiarity. Never compromise on the simulation once a month or every 2 weeks and make each test count. Few students also get frustrated and keep changing resources if they don't score well in mock tests. This is not required. Few students complain that they do not have enough time to go through the explanations after the mock tests. Well, I have a solution for you. Do not attempt to cover all sets of explanations in a singular day. Find a study partner or a study companion, divide the number of questions in 2 to 3 days' time and discuss it over call or in groups. When you discuss the explanations that you faltered in, when you discuss the mistakes that you've made in, you make sure that you will not be repeating these in future. We at Adsorb Law are day in and day out making efforts to provide you a lot of mock tests specific to state patterns for free. Do not miss them out. That is all for today. Tell me in the comment section whether you have started attempting mock tests indeed, or are you still thinking about it. If I've helped you with the video anyway, click the thumbs up button and share this video with a friend. If you haven't subscribed to the channel yet, consider subscribing. Click the bell icon if you want to be notified when we upload our next video. And I will see you in the next one in a bit. Till then, take care. Bye-bye.